Dearly beloved in Christ Jesus, I invite you all to today's program, Oh Jesus, Talk to Me. Dearly beloved, God is going to speak to you today. Are you feeling that I am sowing much but I am not getting anything back? I am expecting so much but I am not getting anything back. God will show you the way to be a blessed person in this world. So do not worry for anything. Let us look at God's word now. Haggai 2:19. Is the seed still in the barn? As yet the vine, the fig tree, the pomegranate and the olive tree have not yielded fruit. But from this day I will bless you. Dear sister, dear brother, from this day God says He will bless you. From this very day He will bless you. Why? You are going to give importance to the work of God from now onwards. In Haggai 2, 6 and 9, we can read. When we read, we can know. The prophet is writing like this. We have sown much, but we are reaping little. We are expecting so much, but there is little coming to us. We are putting money in our pockets, in our pouches. It is coming down without our knowledge. And we are bringing money to our houses, but without our knowledge, we are spending so much and the money is not getting retained in our hands. These are things that is told in Haggai 2, 6 and 9. You can read it. The reason also God says, because they are not giving importance to the temple of God and the work of the temple of God. The temple of God is in ruins. It is not existing, but nobody cares for it. Nobody wants to build it. Nobody wants to resurrect it. They are all after their own works. And God is feeling so much for that. He told, oh, this is not good. Their lives were not fruitful until then. When they turned towards God and His work, God told to them, from this day, from the day that you turn towards my work, I will bless you. When you go to your pastors, your churches, and you do some work there, and you participate in the building of churches and the work of God, wherever God wants you to go and do, when you do that, God will start blessing you abundantly. That's the first thing. Secondly, when you read Genesis 26, 2, 3 and 12, God told to Isaac, yes, it is a time of famine, but do not go to Egypt. Stay in the land where I tell you. And Isaac obeyed the word of God. And he sowed in the land where God told him to sow. And he reaped hundredfold in the very same year that God told him. In the same year, he reaped a hundredfold return. Because he obeyed the voice of God. And he did it. In the same manner, when you give importance to God's work and when you do what God says you to do, God will bless you from this very day. From this day on, God is saying He will bless you. So do not worry for anything. Let us pray now. Lord, I have told them, giving importance to your work and doing what you say and obeying your commands. When we do that, just like Isaac obeyed your voice, Lord, you are saying to these people, I will bless you. He will start to bless you from this very day. From this day on, He will bless you. So do not worry for anything, my brother, my sister. Take heart. Lord, thank you for hearing and answering the prayer. We pray in the mighty name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. O Heavenly Father, Amen. Amen.